Alright guys, what is up? Irving here, recording another episode on the Plunger server. Well, right away you can see there's something that is different from last episode. And I actually gave a clue to it last episode, so this is obviously what happened. I gave a pretty good clue to that. Awesome if you were able to know what I was going to do this episode. Anyways guys, don't think I just did everything off camera. I actually recorded it. I have some clips that I'll show you here after this. First things first though, you can see I have all these things. You'll see me craft them here in a little bit. This is actually going to be my last episode that I record here at home. I am moving, I'm going to college today. The time I upload this episode, I'm going to be at college. It's going to be my first day. And yeah, so recording wise, I have no idea what's going to happen. I don't know if I'm probably going to slow down my episodes a little bit more. I might have to record them on like one day only. I don't know. But I'll try my best to have episodes coming and, you know, so you guys can have something to watch. Anyways, as you can also see right here, I have Carpenter Garage doors. This was Stripe. He decided it was a good idea to fill my base with Carpenter Garage doors. He actually put one there. He put some in the middle, like right here. And he also filled this one because he made a bunch of garage doors. And that's what happened there. He put my heads here. As you can see, I've also expanded the Vibrant Capacitor Bank. I added a row down here and a row up here. Let's see what else. I have added all of these. You could actually see when I was working on this while I was doing the RF Worlds. I was working on this while Nick was actually coming back. While I was waiting for him to go to the Dragon World, I was working on this, and as you can see, it's just a magma crucible with a tank in between. This can hold 128,000 buckets, well, 128 buckets, and then the fluid transposer. All it is back here. I have a bunch of input right there. Oh, export buses, and each one's doing a different one. So it's always exporting when I have in the system that resource. And then the ME interfaces I'm going to use later on so I can automate stuff through there. Alright, so what else have I done? Let's see, I think spawn I did stuff. Oh yeah, this portal here. Stripe actually made a portal gun and he ended up taking the one I had, the Peabody one. This one. So I lost my portal and instead of having him make a new one, I just decided to make a mechanism one. All it is a teleporter and 9 teleporter frames. They're not that bad. Teleporter. As you can see, it's just refined obsidian with glowstone ingot. That makes 9 of these. So you only have to do 2 recipes to do 2 portals. And then these are pretty simple too. The steel casing with some basic control circuits and the teleportation core, which we've done before. And now, with some power, I can actually just, you know, travel from one to the other. I can make it private and everything. I actually have it public so people can come to my base, and I'm just falling through the world. Alright, well, here at spawn, not much has happened. We have Plunger Park now. This is going to be like an amusement park for the whole server. As you can see, some stuff has been going on. We have a little factory that I've been helping Nick. This is actually going to be able to craft solar panels. Right now we've only have it so it goes to right here, solar panel 4. We're working on that. This is a roller coaster Nick made with high speed rails. And I actually exploded it because a chicken got in the way. So yeah, there's an explosion there. That's Stripe's tower. Not going to get in detail on that one. We've got this little game here. I've made this one, which is actually pretty simple. Well, I'm not sure if it's simple, but to me it is. If I turn that on and push this cart, you can see it goes back and forth. And if I hit, I believe, that side. Yeah, you can see that the arrows on the track are going to my side and it's coming over here. And if I hit this side, it makes so that the other target goes down, if you can see there. So It's gonna be like a mini game. Maybe I'll show you guys when I play with someone at a time. We'll see. And this is pretty much it. That's all we have so far for this. But it's gonna be a project for the server to do. Anyways, guys, I think it's time for you guys to see that clip where I've made all this. So I'm gonna get that going. And there you have it, guys. That was how I made all this. It took a while. Let's just say that it took quite a bit. It took like an hour and 30 minutes to get everything: the draconic flux capacitor, the bow, the staff of power, and I've also upgraded my dislocator, so now it's 32 blocks, and I'm happy about that. Anyways, if I show you here in my Emmy system and see what's crafting, you can see I have 12 vibrant capacitor banks crafting. I think 4 of them are already finished. Let's see. Yeah, 4, so I'm actually doing 16. 4, 8 for this side and 8 for this side. So I'm expanding this. But also with expanding more storage, I'm also going to need a way to power it. Well, to have more powers in order to fill that storage. So I've actually been saying that I would have done this a long time ago, and I still haven't done it. But it is time to get that Beef Wellington farm going, so we can actually make power out of the culinary generators. And also, if I show you over here, I actually have 2 octuple compressed cobblestone. And if I look at NEI, octuple compressed uses on this. If you smelt this, you get a block of bedrockium, which you can turn into the ingots. And the ingots you can actually use you can use it to make the 64 times generator. So I can make the culinary generator. I can make this one, the 6 times 64. As you can see, it uses the bedrockium there. So I'm actually really excited about that. I'm going to do like a bunch of these. I'm just going to stack them on top of each other. I'm probably going to do most of it on camera, but I will do some progress upgrades updates. So I'm going to get that going. All right, guys. So some progress has been made. As you can see, I filled, all these layers with stone road. As you can see, there are like from this platform to this platform is 5 blocks. So there's 4 blocks from here, from the top of this to the bottom of that one. So that way I have space to like, in if I'm gonna ever put like ores under it, I have a space for that, and I still have like a way to get in and out easily, so I would have headroom. All right, so now the next thing I need is a bunch of dirt. As you can see, I used up a lot of stone. I had my inventory full of that, so let's actually go get some dirt real quick here on camera so you can see. I have a lot of dirt. Yeah, a lot of dirt. I can actually put some of this away. I don't think I'm going to need more than a stack. So I'm just going to grab a bunch of dirt. That's good enough. How is this doing? Oh, it's done. Vibrant capacitor. 16 of them. Look at that. It's going to drain from this, isn't it? Is it? I don't see it. Oh, well, anyways, I'm going to get rid of that head. That head. How much is it? 900 million RF. That's how much this can hold. I'm just going to turn all of these into the little panels things. And I just teleported to this side. Can I actually pick things up now? Yes, I can. And this, the torches, I guess I can do that. Place that down. Look at that. Oh, now there's that. Yeah, I grabbed way too much dirt. Let's pick this stuff up. I'll put my heads here. My 2 desks that I still only have. I didn't even place them right, but whatever. I'll fix that off camera. And then just all of these, like so. Boom, look at that, guys. 900 million RF, I mean. I keep on messing that number up. All right, well, anyways, I am going to go fill everything with dirt. Well, just these layers. All I'm going to do is just place, this is 18 long. I kind of messed that up too, because there is no center to this. So I'm actually using 2 harvesters. I think that's what I'm going to do with this also. And then I'm just going to do one side like this and then the other side. And that's what I'm going to be doing for all these layers. All right. Well, I'll see you once I have done that. Aha! It is done. I have filled all of these with dirt. As you can see, I had to make a hole in all of them for the water. And I am also converting this top one to mycelium for mushrooms. I actually want to do this below, below this, but I kind of made an extra one up here, so I'm just like, I'll just use that instead. So that's why it's up here. And the reason I'm making a tower is because that way I can only chunk load. Like, I only had to chunk load this and not have to chunk load more chunks. That's why I'm going upwards with this. So that's going to be a plus for that. I haven't filled this in because right now this is using the solar generators. And also, you can see that some of these cannot grow because this is blocking sunlight. So what I'm going to do is use glowstone covers. I'm going to place them every once in a while, like here on the corners. Like so, like one here, one here. All right, and like one here. And I think most of these should be able to grow now. I'll have to check each one. These can't grow. I'll do the rest of this off camera. I'm going to put glowstone like on the bottom of all these. And then I'll get all the harvesters and stuff I need. And then I'll be back. Alright guys, and I think I have everything prepared. I have 16 harvesters, 16 upgrades iron, a bunch of conduits, trash cans, tesseracts. I need some more item conduits, but I'll get that here in a little bit. So the way I want to do this is I want to do this for this 9x9. This one for that 9x9. And then on this side, do the same thing. Let's see, one there, one there. All right, and there we go. We can start adding these upgrades real quick. It shouldn't take too long, just a little bit of clicking. If I can hit those. Let's see, there we go. The way I'm just going to connect them is just going straight down. I have two tesseracts, one for each side. That way I don't have to struggle with wires across this whole thing. For that top one, I think I'm going to use dark glass like I have used over there for the mob spawner. Alright, so now I just need to put the trash cans. Alright, now for the power, I think I'm just going to run it right next to it in the inside of all of them. Just break down a little bit too far, but whatever. I'll probably go a little bit too far on this one too, but let's go down. Okay, now the other side. Alright, now conduits all the way from the bottom. Let's go down, please. Okay, there's one side done. I don't know where to connect this. I'm guessing down here is probably the best way. Put a tesseract, it's not centered. I forgot about that. how do I want to do this since there's no center? Alright, so I'm just gonna forget about the centering and just put it there. Have this go here and this connect like so. Set this like so. Disable everything except for the energy receive. And then my base power. There we go. So now all these should be getting power. They are. That is great. Now let's do the other side. Okay, now the tesseract all the way at the bottom here. Let's see, I did that one closer to that side, so I'll do this one closer to the other side. And tesseract. Ignored. Just the energy. And then Irving's base power, set frequency. They should all be getting power now. Yes. Alright, that looks golden. Now we just need to make it so that items go down. I'm just going to do the same thing, except, that's what I should do. I'm going to have this pass underneath, and then I can have the ender chest right next to it, like this. And I have them yellow, yellow, yellow. Anyways, I think I'm going to do this part of camera. This. Okay. And the ender chest. All right, well, I'm going to do the rest off camera. I'm going to connect everything the way it needs to be. And I'm going to plant everything so all of these are planted. I'm going to fill this top part. And then I'll see you after that. All right, guys. And it is done. Holy cow. A few years later. Dude, this just took way too long to use the clippers and spread them all over that. Because this is 20 by 20, I believe. As you can see, there's some light coming through there. So those aren't growing. I'll fix that later. But let's actually set up the storage system. I already started here with one storage unit, a deep storage unit with spinach. I have three more on me, so let's place these down. This one's gonna be wheat, this one's gonna be soybeans, and this one's gonna be, there we go, mushroom. Gonna lock all of these. There we go. And then set these to insert. Click that, please. Insert. And one more. There you go. Now we can put this ender chest here. This is where everything's gonna go. And this is gonna be set on export. Always active. There we go. So I think we are ready. It is time to turn this thing on. So let's start flicking these. Whoa, and look at the frame rate. I am feeling it. I should probably move this away from my base. Actually, I'm gonna move my base, so I'm actually gonna leave this here. But look at that. That is crazy. You can see my frames just start. It looks like I'm dropping stuff because I'm not pulling them out fast enough. That should fix itself, I believe. And I think that's all of them. Look at all that stuff. I'm actually gonna, full inventory. Is this full? Yeah, that's the problem. I'm not pulling them out fast enough. So I'm gonna have to work on that in between episodes. Let's just finish this, put this in there. The wheat goes in here. How about that, guys? This is like all the resources I needed. Perfect. And just these. Got another spinach over here. Alright, guys. Well, I think that's going to be it for this episode. This episode has been going for a while. It's been a pain to make. It has taken so long to make that right there. But I am really happy to have that done. Now, next episode, we are going to make the culinary generators. And actually make all of these materials into the beef Wellington, that way we can actually use it for power. So that's going to be next episode. Also, guys, I need you guys to help support the channel, like this video if you liked it, and also make sure to subscribe because I need all your help now that I'm going to college. I need all the support I can get to keep this channel going, so I need you guys to help me with that. Anyways, guys, that's going to be it. See you guys next time. Bye.